has taken the Clippers to him. Much hilarity from his cricketing mates, I noticed. Ricky Clark and a few others weighing in on social media. So you're telling us this afternoon about your hairdressing mishaps and maybe getting some advice from a professional, because Andy's wife, Sue, is a coiffeuse. She is at home, or where else would she be at the moment, with Andy. So she can give some of the listeners some top tips. So we're going to kick off with Shark Olive on Twitter. It said, dear Sue, my wife's first attempt at cutting hair, not sure she likes me. Can you recommend anything? Now, to try and explain what's gone on with Shark Olive, he's got a kind of very small tuft of hair. It's a bit Taxi Driver, Robert De Niro, but it's just a tuft. It looks like the top of a pineapple. Sue, have you had a look at this? Is there anything he can do with that, you think?
Yeah, now, Sue, Paul's asking if there's anything you can do with Shark Olive. We've got him in front of us. You know, you quite liked that one, didn't you?
I did. Is his hair normally like that?
Well, apparently not. He said his wife did it to him.
What's his hair normally like? What's his wife done that's different?
His wife did it to him.
Yeah, but how is his hair normally? Well, is it not like a Mohican?
We don't know.
I don't have that picture, really. I can't give you any more than that.
Let's see on before and after. She likes it, that's why.
Oh, that's cool. That's a start then. So Shark Olive, it's probably not your real name. Just leave it as is.
I agree that she doesn't like you. I think it's good.
Keep that one going. Okay, we've got another one here. Another one here.
Stop talking.
Where's this one come from? Where am I? My wife cut my hair, a number 3 all over last night. She tried to blend it. Not the best outcome. How do you blend it in? Needless to say, I'm wearing a cap for a while. And did he put his name on that? Let's have a look. That was from Paul Ward. Thank you,
Paul Ward. It's Paul Ward. It's this one.
This one. But no, you can't blend that in. You have to do the whole back like that. And then when you get to the top of that section that's shaved practically, use a number 2 or 3 up to the crown, 3 probably.
Okay.
That might blend it in a little bit. But apart from that, you just need to shave the whole back off, basically.
Oh, well, Paul, get the old clippers out again.
As well.
You've got a nice voice. Have you ever thought of going into radio?
Yeah. Nicer than Andy's, I'll tell you that. So, Jimmy Bob White's been in touch, Sue. He said, can you ask Sue has any tips for my hair? I'm starting to look like Robinson Crusoe. Actually, you're starting to look like Andy Zortzman looking at the picture. Have you got that picture, Andy?
Quite mad hair.
So, what can he do with that?
That you try and even up the two sides, because one's a lot shorter than the other.
Yeah.
So, even them up as much as you can. And then put loads of mousse on what you've got left. And scrunch it like as if you're squeezing a sponge, just to get it into shape. It'll make it look like it's in much better condition. And don't comb it afterwards, just let it dry up naturally.
What about that? It's all good stuff.
I've got Rob Key on my laptop there, his picture of his back.
Yeah, well, Rob Key is in a very similar situation to one of the other listeners who's done exactly the same thing. So this is Paul Ward's attempt to sort out this one that Sue was talking about there. So I think the advice to Rob Key is the same as it is to Paul Ward, isn't it, Sue? Which is the big stripe up the back of there. The wrong setting on the clippers.
So it's this fellow here.
They've both done the same thing.
Yeah, they've both done the same thing. Where is it?
It's a disaster.
Yeah. It's a disaster.
Is there anything you can do if you put a stripe up?
Shave
so you've basically
the whole
got
rest of the back
off.
And then you could possibly try and blend it in by using number 2 or number 3 towards the crown. First, maybe number 2 a little bit towards the crown, and then maybe number 3 a little bit towards the crown, then maybe number 4 a little bit towards the crown would blend in a bit.
Okay, got a couple of quick questions. Jamie says, would you recommend a novice using thinning scissors on themselves?
Would you recommend a novice using thinning scissors on themselves?
Yes, definitely. Okay. Thinning scissors aren't a disaster. They're quite easy to use.
And Danny says, I have a good head of hair that comes complete with a cow's lick. I'm thinking of running the clippers over it for a grade 2 freshen up. I need Sue's advice on this, as I'm not sure how the cow's lick would look. Is that a tongue twister?
Okay, he's got a cow's lick, and he's thinking of doing a grade 2 over it, this fellow.
See, like Tony Castorino and Robert Pires.
We've only got one set of headphones.
I know.
What are you supposed to do with that?
Okay, the cow's lick at the front.
No, the back, isn't it? Oh, the front.
Is it the front? Yeah.
Cow's lick, sorry. Well, I wouldn't interfere with it, really.
Yeah, don't interfere with your cow's lick.
I mean, you don't want to shave it off, do you?
No, that's...
Well, he was thinking of it, but I don't...
Don't mess, Danny. Don't mess with a cow's lick. It's only going to make it worse. Sue, thank you very much. I've got the feeling this could have its own music bed and become a regular feature. And good luck with the table tennis. So there we are.
Bob from Our Breath. I'm trying to improve my table tennis backhand. Any tips, please?
No, she doesn't give tips on table tennis, just hairdressing. So there we are. Fantastic.
Oh, yeah,
ask Sue.
Fantastic, wasn't it?
Our little section there.
Yes.
Our star is born.
I'm not sure about that.
Yeah. So let's bring you day 16 of Striker. We should set the scene.